Group discussion, do's and don't.
Now we will talk about group discussion, do's and don'ts. As you have to participate in a group discussion, several questions spring across your mind. You want to know what actions and gestures can get you positive points and what can cost you the selection. Here is a list of do's and don'ts.
Do's: keep eye contact while speaking. Do not look at the evaluators only. Keep eye contact with every team member while speaking. Make original points and support them by substantial reasoning. Facts and statistics should be provided if known. Listen to the other participants actively and carefully. Be considerate to the feelings of others. Modulate the volume, pitch, and tone of your voice. Speak clearly. Talk with the confidence and self-assurance. Allow others to speak. Make sure to bring the discussion on track. Avoid irrelevant details. Take time to organize your thoughts. Think about what you are going to say. Don't start speaking until you have clearly understood and analyzed the subject. Opening the discussion is not the only way of gaining attention and recognition. Try to give valuable insights during the discussion. Be assertive but not dominating. Try to maintain a balanced tone in your discussion and analysis. Always be polite. Try to avoid using strong phrases such as "I strongly object" or "I disagree completely." Instead, it is advisable to use phrases such as "I would like to share my views on" or "One difference between your point and mine is." Remember names, facts, figures, quotations, etc. It helps a lot if you know who has spoken what. If permitted, you can use a notepad to write. Don'ts: being shy or nervous or keeping isolated from group discussion. This defeats the purpose of the group discussion and leaves the employer with a bad impression of you. Interrupting another participant before his arguments are over. As mentioned earlier, it is important to demonstrate good social behavior and people skills. Changed opinions. It is important not to change your statements or views over the course of the discussions. This demonstrates to the judges that your initial view was not well thought out. Don't make fun of any participant, even if his arguments are funny. Don't engage yourself in subgroup conversation. Don't repeat and use irrelevant materials. Addressing you to the examiner. It is important to maintain eye contact and speak directly to the other participants in the group discussion. Worrying about making some grammatical mistakes. The matter you put across is more important. As long as your arguments are well thought out and sensible, small grammatical errors may be forgiven.
Apart from the above points, the panel will also judge team members for their alertness, presence of mind, problem-solving abilities, ability to work as a team without alienating certain members, and creativity. Friends, don't be disheartened if you did not do well in your first group discussion. The best possible preparation for a group discussion is to learn from your past mistakes.